goodness, you're still here?
At this rate, I will be here until tomorrow morning.
Why? Can't you handle Evan's figures?
Yes, I can handle them, Iris. There's just so many of them.
Oh, dear, I was hoping you'd be able to cover for his absence.
I will, Iris. You're just going to have to give me some time, all right?
Well, I trust you're on top of the Adams Beauty Care account.
You gave that to Vicky.
Uh-huh. But as publisher of this magazine, you're responsible for everything.
Fine.
I trust I'll have your report on my desk in the morning.
Yes, I'll have it.
Goody. Now I'm off to Josie's little get-together.
You're going to a party.
Well, somebody has to handle public relations. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Wendy, I need to see Vicky Hudson immediately. What do you mean she's not in the building? Where could she... She's where? Hello?
Vicky.
Cliff.
Well, I didn't expect...
I told you I had blonde hair and blue eyes.
But you didn't tell me you were so...
stunning.
Or witty.
I wanted to surprise you.
And you have. This is definitely going to be more interesting than I expected.
Well, for both of us, I hope. That was fast.
Well, you said it couldn't wait.
Come in.
So what is it? What do you want to talk to me about?
I want to ask you a question, and I want you to tell me the truth. Did you persuade Lucas not to hire me and Jake?
I hit three costume places before I found one that had a habit my size.
I don't believe this.
You should see me driving over here. Boy, St. Christopher. A nun doing 80 miles per hour in a sports car.
How did you get in here?
Oh, Mother Superior let me in. She and I had a lovely, lovely nun-to-nun talk. I told her I had to see you.
But she bought the whole thing?
Oh, I would look very devout. Well, I prefer to think of it as ingenuity.
You weaseled this out of Charlotte.
I never weasel, Frankie. I grovel.
I come here for peace and quiet, and what do I get? Sacrilege. I want you out of here.
Oh, no way.
Now!
I didn't become a sister for nothing, you know.
Oh, yes, you did.
I'm staying, Frankie.
Mary Frances.
Reverend Mother.
I thought I heard arguing. Is there a problem? There isn't a problem?
We weren't arguing. We were debating.
Rather forcefully, if I may say so.
Oh, I did get a bit zealous there, didn't it? It's over now. I think that we should get back to cleaning up the kitchen, so I have asked Sister Cassandra to lend me a hand.
I'll leave it to you then.
Thank you.
Sister Cassandra?
I knew you wouldn't turn me in.
I was this close.
Yeah, but you didn't do it. It's because you still care for me.
What I care about is getting you psychiatric help. This is wacko, city councilor.
You wanted to get away from the cares of the world and reflect, right?
That is what I wanted to do.
Well, I'm letting you do that.
No, you're not.
Keep your voice down.
You are the world that I wanted to get away from, and you're here.
I won't bother you.
Look at me. I bother.
Shh.
Now will you get out of here?
Hey, what the hell was that?
Mary Frances. I'm not sure I explained the bell to you.
No, you didn't.
It signals the beginning of a period of silent meditation. For the next hour, everyone in the convent must observe strict silence.
Lucas? I mean, Lucas, is the reason that you called me over here to talk to me?
Why else would I have called you?
Well, I thought maybe you'd want to... Forget it, Donna. What is it you wanted to know about Lucas? Why?
Did you tell him not to hire us?
Yes, I did.
Why would you do that to me, Michael?
Lucas is a dangerous man, Donna.
Lucas saved your life.
And there are a lot of people who are not happy about that.
So what does that have to do with me?
They are going to come after him, Donna. He's a marked man.
Then why does he still have his position as Sophisticate?
Well, I have a feeling it's because Iris is in love with him, and maybe because Rachel is on vacation. I don't know.
Well, thanks to you, my business may be in danger of failing, Michael.
Look, your business does not depend on Lucas, all right?
You may not tell me who I can associate with. We're not living together as husband and wife any longer.
Not at the moment, no.
I can take care of myself, Michael.
Donna, you don't know Lucas, and you don't know the cartel, all right?
What do you think I am, some naive little idiot? Yes. You do. You have absolutely no respect for me.
It's
You're trying to treat me the same way you did before you left.
Donna, what I did because I believed it was the right thing, all right? And you, or nobody else, is going to convince me I did
when
the wrong
thing. You stopped her from working with Lucas, Michael. You also stopped me. What about that?
Jarlsberg, Gouda, Brie, whatever that is. What else? What else?
Crackers.
Yes! No, no.
No?
Not crackers, biscuits. They are called imported biscuits. I'll get them.
Yeah.
She take the plastic wrap off the cheeses.
Reuben, quick, take the plastic...
Plastic wrap off the cheeses.
She has put out a ludicrous amount of...
Or did I already do it? Reuben, I might have already done it.
And those flowers, it looks like somebody died.
I almost forgot the breadsticks, macadamias, cashews, and peanuts.
Josie, good heavens, is this all you're putting out?
Why, what do you mean?
No marinated artichoke hearts?
Marinated? I didn't buy any.
Oh. Well, I suppose you can get away with it since it's your first party.
Oh, no.
What?
What if I didn't get enough mountain spring water?
Josie!
I got 10 bottles, but unless I could serve them tap water and tell them it's mountain spring water, they'll never know.
But Josie, will you listen to me?
What?
You have more than enough of everything. Look at this. You're gonna have such a hot party.
Yeah, if anybody shows up. What if nobody... Oh, no! Please, don't let that be one of the guests.
Why not?
Because I'm not ready.
Josie, you've been ready for the past 2 hours.
I mean emotionally. I'm not centered. I'm not calm. My hands are sweating.
Shall I answer the
door? No. 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 Nobody move. Just a minute. I'm gonna go change.
What?
I'll be right back.
Josie, you are not gonna change your clothes now.
Even the most important people from Sophisticate are going to be here. And what if Lucas isn't impressed?
Josie, you look great, okay? Now you're gonna turn around, a wonderful time, a fun time, and answer your door.
Answer my door.
Yeah.
I'm gonna answer my door. Hi! Hello, I'm so glad you could make it.
Nice to see you again, Josie.
You too. I hope it wasn't too inconvenient getting here. I hope you like the food. Oh, come in.
Great apartment, Josie.
Thank you. I think it's on the small side, but I find it cozy, not to mention clean. One always does clean before a party. Reuben, Olivia, I want you to meet my friends, Graham and... Oh, I'm terrible with names.
Narissa.
Narissa, of course. This is Reuben and Olivia.
It's a pleasure.
It's really nice to meet you. I'm sorry, what's your names again?
Graham. Where do we put our coats?
Oh, your coats.
In the bedroom.
In the bedroom. I'll put them in the bedroom. I'll hang them up so they don't get all wrinkled.
I'll take these. Right. Excuse me.
You'll have to forgive her first party nerves and everything.
Of course.
Mushroom, Narissa?
Ooh, marvelous. Excuse me. I'm leaving.
What?
Wait.
The party just started, Olivia. Don't tell me it's boring already.
Josie, it'll be fine if you just relax. I just need some fresh air, that's all.
Could you get that? I've got to take care of these coats. Would you mind? Thanks.
Sure. Hi, Matthew.
Hey, I heard there's a wild and crazy party up here, so
oh,
I came
up. Yeah, it's incredible. It's okay. Happening. What a bash. Bye.
Hey, where are you going?
As far away as I can get. Oh, and I would stay away from the stuffed mushrooms if I were you. They're still frozen in the middle.
Yeah, thank you. Hey, Reuben, how's it going?
Oh. Hi. Fine.
Frozen in the middle, huh?
Yeah. A girl called Josie. She's a freak.
Where is she?
Oh. You!
Hey!
I'm so glad you could make it. You don't know how nervous I...
What?
What are you wearing?
Well, let's see here. I'm wearing jeans, a shirt, a little aftershave. I got this one.
This is an elegant party.
An elegant party? Oh, darn it. I thought this was a regular old inelegant party. If I'd only known.
Serious, Matthew.
Come on, Josie. He looks fine.
Wait a minute. Apparently I don't. And I am humiliated. I mean, look at all your fancy friends, all spiffed and color-coordinated.
I might hear you.
Oh, heaven forbid they hear me.
You could have at least worn something halfway decent.
This is what I wear, Josie.
For a frat party, maybe.
For any party.
Even when the guests are on the cutting edge.
Did she actually say that, Reuben? Did she actually say this is the cutting edge?
Yes, and this cutting edge happens to be important to my career. I thought you understood that. Excuse me.
Look, she's just a little nervous, man, okay?
About what? I don't even know why she had this party in the first place.
Lucas, you came!
Would I miss your party?
Now I know.
How do I look?
You look terrific.
So do you. So distinguished. Now I know my party's going to be just fine.
Florence is definitely my favorite city.
Ah, yes.
I love all the cathedrals and architecture.
Firenze.
I love it there, too.
Vicky, you're wonderful.
I am. Thank you.
And you spoke nothing but Italian the whole time you were there.
Well, languages always have been a passion of mine, yes.
That and movies, food, music, anything else?
Oh, there are a few more things.
I'm anxious to hear about all of them.
Well, I'll be happy to tell you about them.
Yeah, that's right. One beef and one chicken. Ah, listen, could you send some nachos with that as well? Right, that's it. Thanks a lot. Hi, Olivia.
Sam.
Sorry, didn't mean to startle you.
I didn't think you'd be here this time of day.
Well, I didn't think I'd be here this time of day either.
I don't want to interrupt your work.
Olivia, when I gave you the key, I said use the place whenever you want to.
Yes, I know when I needed a place to practice my dancing.
Or if you wanted to get away from everyone and everything.
You did say that, didn't you?
Yeah. Is that why you're here?
As a show?
Well, you didn't bring your dance clothes. So what happened?
Oh, Josie's having a party, and I just didn't feel up to it. All those people she works with.
Yeah, I'm not too into parties myself.
So why are you here tonight?
Amanda had a late meeting, and I need some art supplies, so...
So I suppose you'll get your supplies and then leave?
Actually, no. I've just finished ordering dinner.
You did?
Yeah, you know, enchiladas, tacos, nachos, all the stuff you hate.
Who's this?
Come on, I thought you were a health food freak.
Well, not all of the time. In fact, I've been craving Mexican lately.
Yeah?
Did you order chicken enchiladas or beef?
Both, actually. So which do you prefer?
I don't eat red meat.
Oh, well, then you get the chicken.
Are you inviting me to dinner?
Unless you have something better to do.
No. Mm-mm, that'd be great.
Will you just excuse me for one moment? Thank you. What is your problem?
Why aren't you at the office?
Because I'm here.
We are working a 16-hour day, and you're here at Tubbs picking up men?
Wrong.
That's great.
Go, Amanda.
Iris, trusted you with the Adams account, and the very least that you can do is do the work, all right? Yeah, you and I have to get together a strategy and lay it on her desk by tomorrow morning.
All right.
You got yourself into this. Now, the very least you can do is do the work.
All right? Are you finished?
Yes, I'm finished. Okay. Let's go.
Now, if you would, let's...
If I'm interrupting, it's strictly intentional.
I'm sorry, Vicky's gonna have to leave, Mr.
Adams. Amanda Fowler, I would like you to meet Mr. Cliff Adams, the president of Adams Cosmetics.
Hello. It's nice to meet you.
Amanda is the publisher of Sophisticate. I've told you many things about her.
Oh, and it's been fascinating. I'm sorry you and Vicky have to leave.
We don't, do
we? No, not just yet. I was just discussing a minor office problem with Vicky, and she assures me that there's no reason to worry, so...
Oh, I hope so. I heard that Evan Bates resigned.
No, actually, he's just on a temporary leave of absence.
Yes, there was a novel that he wanted to write.
But the financial department, it's still in good shape.
Mr. Adams is interested in putting more advertising space into Sophisticate, Amanda.
Well, I think that's a great idea for you, Mr. Adams.
Please, Cliff. Yes. Vicky's made a very strong proposal, but I still have a few questions.
Well, sure, go ahead, ask away. I have most of the information here with me.
Now, the terms of the agreement aren't completely clear to me.
Uh-huh. I was trying to explain it on a sliding scale.
Well, I can lay it out for you.
I'm sure Amanda has all the latest circulation figures as well as the demographics.
Mm-hmm.
It's intriguing to me. But I'm sure that would take considerable research.
We've already hired an independent research team.
Yes,
we?
They're great. Unless, of course, you have somebody that you would rather use.
That would be fine with us.
Uh-huh. So, we can give you the best space. I'm sure Vicky told you that.
Cover layout, double-centered layout.
So all you have to do is have your art director call our art director and see what they can work out.
That's a good idea.
I've heard a lot of good ideas today.
Yes, well, Vicky can be very innovative.
I have to admit, I had reservations about this trip when I found out I wouldn't be meeting with Evan Bates.
Well, Evan has been a loss for the time being, but we are learning to cope without him.
Well, you're more than coping.
Hmm?
I'm very reassured.
Good.
Good. We're very pleased to hear you say that.
I'll be in touch.
I'll look forward to hearing from you.
Tomorrow. We'll talk tomorrow.
Good.
It's very nice to meet you, Amanda.
Oh, same here. Thank you.
Vicky, I had a wonderful time.
So did I. Thank you.
No, don't you two work too hard.
Oh.
Make sure you have a little fun.
We'll be sure to do that. Ciao.
How am I supposed to know what you were doing?
I didn't know it was going to work so well, but we got on.
It went well. It went well. You actually did well.
You weren't bad, except for the novel part. But we landed him.
Yes, the Adams account.
Wait until Iris hears.
You tell Iris I'm going home. Vicky, have you seen Evan? How is he?
You've got to be kidding me that you're asking
Just
me that
tell
question.
Tell me how he is.
I don't know.
Really?
I don't.
Yeah, this is Evan Bates. Fine. Listen, I need you to sell 200 shares of the AT&T stock and replace it with municipal bonds at high yield.
What?
I'm so sober as a judge. What are you talking about? Just do as I say. Now, I want you to keep an eye on Brava stock. I'm working on a plan. Well, I'm freelancing now. You see, I get to make my own hours. I make my calls when I want. It's better being that way. You know what I mean? It's better on my own that way.
Well, tell Josie I felt uncomfortable in my jeans.
She didn't mean that.
I don't care what she meant. She's falling all over herself trying to be part of this group she invited over here. If you ask me, they're the ones she should be embarrassed.
She works with these people.
Well, obviously, they're the ones she cares about. She hasn't left Lucas for a second.
Are you more relaxed now?
A little bit.
This party is terrific.
I don't know.
Come on, look around. Everybody's having a ball.
Do you think the music is too loud?
No, everything is fine.
except for me. I don't fit in, Lucas.
Would you stop it? Of course you do, honey. You fit in perfectly. You're as gorgeous as anybody in this room. This is your crowd.
Do you really think so?
Yes. This is your world.
Iris dropped by today.
Ah, Iris actually made someone's mood better.
She wanted to talk to me about something.
Oh, fresh faces, Gambay, no.
No, no. She came over to tell me not to get involved with Lucas.
What?
Lucas.
But she told you, well, I don't know.
Not that anything's going on between us, of course.
Oh.
It's all on Iris's mind. Don't you see?
No. No.
She sees me as competition.
Hmm. Well, that's why you're in this mood? That turns you on?
It doesn't turn me on. It's just flattering. Here is this powerful, successful, glamorous woman, and she sees me as her rival.
What an ego trip for you.
No, it's not that. It just makes me feel powerful myself.
Excuse me. I'd like to talk to Josie alone for a minute.
Of course, Matt.
Thank you.
I'll find you in a few minutes, Lucas.
Sure.
I bet you will.
What is your problem?
You're the one with the problem, kissing up all these phony jerks, trying to fit in with a bunch of creeps.
They are not creeps.
Fine, Josie, have fun.
You just can't be happy for me, can you? For the first time in my life, I feel like I belong, and you just can't be happy for me. Hi, I'm back.
Oh, hi, where's Matthew?
Oh, he's circulating.
Oh, good.
Could I talk to you alone for a minute?
Sure. What?
Nothing. I just wanted to talk to you.
Okay.
Lucas, I can't decide what to wear for the luncheon on Friday, and I thought maybe you could help me decide. Yeah, should I
Lucas,
go casual?
Darling, or... Hi.
You.
Fine. Sorry I'm late. Have I missed much?
You know, good pair. I have something for you. If the Mother Superior knew why I was here, she wouldn't hold me to silence. You better really love what I brought you, especially seeing what they feed you around this place.
Sisters like good, hearty food.
Yeah, but you're into health food. Not stew with fatty beef and salty pork that they dip in a heavy flour gravy.
I can pick out the vegetables.
What would you say to a wheat germ and granola carob cake? Hmm?
No.
No? You said no?
You heard me.
I heard you, but I don't believe you. Why don't I leave it right here, just in case? Okay?
Are you going to help me clean up or what?
Sure. When do we hack up the salt pork? You know, all of that saturated fat oozes into everything, including the veggies. Did you know that? And very succulent. It'll put hair on your chest, that's for sure.
You are not going to provoke me, Cass.
Wouldn't dream of it, Frankie.
If this is you being silent, I would hate to be around when you have something to say.
Oh, I have plenty to say. I think you should live life the way you want to.
I'm trying.
How? By denying yourself?
Coffee now?
You can't change what you are or what you want by hiding behind these walls. I want you to realize that.
Come on, Harden.
You wanted your cake, and you want me too. Silent meditation, Mary Frances. That's good. Silent meditation.
I think you and I should have a little talk alone, Michael.
Now, personally, I think that's a very, very good idea.
Well, I don't.
Give us a couple minutes, Donna.
I think I have a right to hear what's going on.
You had your chance to talk to him. Now it's my turn.
Very well.
So, What's on your mind?
I am trying to build a business here. I don't need you around to screw it up.
I'm not trying to screw it
up. Let me finish.
I know what you're going to say.
You pull another stunt like that, Michael, and I will make you sorry you ever interfered.
What is this macho talk, Jake? I'm trying to protect Donna, that's all.
Protect her from what?
From Lucas. He is a dangerous man. He's big trouble, man.
So you say,
007. No, so I know. So I know, buddy. He is dangerous. I'm trying to protect her from danger. It's that simple.
I don't think it is, Michael. I don't think it's that simple.
I don't really care what you think.
Is this about Lucas? Or do you want Donna to fail so she'll come crawling back to you?
I have a feeling it's more your tactics than mine, Jake.
Or is it me? Are you trying to punish Donna because she's in business with me?